Good evening. Today we can continue our class in physics. So far we have discussed about reflection of light. If you understand the reflection of light correct or thoroughly, that will be very useful for refraction of light. Very similar principle, some modification is there. So, what is a fundamental understand about refraction of light? Usually when light travels from one medium to another medium, you should not compare with reflection. Reflection, both the rays are in the same media. Only for refraction, two media are necessary. Light has to travel from one medium to another, automatically deviates its path. The path of the ray deviates, called refraction. So that I have given the statement like that, when a ray of light is incident on the boundary between two transparent media, a part of it passes into second medium with a change in direction. That is called, the direction changes. So that is called deviate. Then we call it as refraction. Similarly, the reflection of light, refraction also, two surfaces, refraction at the plane surface and refraction at the spherical surface. First we have seen refraction at a plane surface. So in this diagram, plane surface, this is a plane refracting surface which is separate two media. So this media may be rarer, this media may be denser. Suppose if light rays travel from rarer medium to denser medium, what happens? Actually it goes straight, it not go like that, but it deviate towards the normal. That is a thing you have to understand it. When light travel from rarer medium to denser medium, the refracted ray bend towards the normal. So this is called angle of incidence. This is called angle of refraction, where I is always greater than R. So another case also possible as far as refraction is concerned. If light travels from denser medium to rarer medium, reverse. That is also light comes like that, but it goes like that, but not so. The refracted ray bend away from the normal. If it bends away from the normal, also deviation called refraction. So we have to concentrate whether light travels from rarer medium to denser medium or denser medium to rarer medium. If it from rarer to denser, refracted ray bend towards the normal. If it from denser to rarer, the refracted ray bend away from the normal. So here also, this is I, this is R. Kindly go through, here R is greater than I. If R is greater than I, we can come to the conclusion that light travels from denser medium to rarer medium. What is a denser and a rarer medium? That will explain by the Snell's law. So here also the loss of refraction will be there. Just like where loss of reflection. What are loss of refraction? There is an incident ray, the refracted ray and a normal ray lie on the same plane, the same as like that of your reflection. The second law only differs. There the second law, angle of I equal to angle of reflection. So here the second law called Snell's law. Snell's law holds good only for the first condition. Light has to travel from rarer to denser. That means mu is equal to sin I by sin R. That is called second law. That means the ratio of sin of angle of incidence to the sine of angle of refraction always constant. That constant is called mu. That mu is called refractive index. So something we are having mu 1 2 or mu 2 1, like that we can put R 1 2. That means refractive index of the second medium with respect to first. So what is the answer will be the refractive index of the second medium. Denser medium we can get it by using this formula, and this formula is called Snell's law. What is called mu? Mu is a constant. That constant name is refractive index. That is called refractive index. So Medium has different value of refractive index. For I'll give in the slide. For vacuum, it become 1. For vacuum only, the refractive index 1. For air, it become 1.0003. So, a lot of difference, because it is entrance examination, there is a minor difference between 1 and 1.0003. 1.0003 is the refractive index of air, 1 is refractive index of vacuum, refractive index of water 1.33, refractive index of glass 1.55. Like the refractive index value changes, any medium has more refractive index is called denser medium. Any medium has lesser refractive index called rarer medium. So, the medium can be only comparable, it is only ratio. So, kindly make note of this. If any medium denser, it is not always denser. We have to compare with the other medium. If two media are given, kindly go through the refractive index of the two media given. We can come to the conclusion that one medium has more refractive index, other has less, means the more refractive index is called denser medium, the less refractive index is called rarer medium. That is a thing we have to understand it. Okay. So, that was given in the slides. So, this just now I told the incident ray, refractive ray and the normal ray lie on the same plane. Snell's law mu 2 1 or some book mu 2 1 or 1 mu 2. That is also correct. Refractive index of the second medium with respect to 1. Refractive index of the second medium with respect to 1. So, that can be modified in terms of velocity of light. That is a wave theory. We are going to detailly about wave theory in the next year, the 12th standard portion in the 5th unit. Among that is related to refractive index, so that I want to discuss here. The refractive index, the first problem may be asked in the refraction means, the refractive index problem. The formula for refractive index, you have to keep your mind. The first formula, mu is equal to sin I by sin R. If you are given the angle of incidence and angle of refraction, simply substituted, we can able to find out refractive index. So, another formula, if the velocity of the media are given, C1 is the velocity of the first medium, C2 is the velocity of the second medium is a denser, like that. Then, refractive index of the denser medium can also be calculated by using the formula C1 by C2. This is another formula. Some modification I want to discuss. In general, the refractive index equal to C by Cm. What is called C? Velocity of light in rarer medium, that means in air usually. Cm, velocity of light in the medium. We can calculate the value of refractive index of the medium. It's a general formula, C1 by C2 or mu is equal to C by Cm. What do you conclude here? The rarer medium should be, velocity should be in the numerator, denser medium velocity in the denominator. What does it mean? It means the refractive index always greater than 1. Don't forget it. The refractive index is always greater than 1, not less than 1. That is a mu. One important thing, which element has maximum refractive index? That is also question asked in entrance examination. We know water 1.3, glass 1.5, like that. The maximum refractive index one element has means, which one is a usual problem or usual question asked? So far discovered, the maximum refractive index is diamond. Diamond has maximum refractive index. Slide is not coming in order. So we have to analyze it. That is, the refractive index plays an important role. Which element has maximum refractive index? Diamond. Diamond, you know, everyone experience? You know, it is a very costly element. Usually ladies are attracted by diamond. What is the reason? Because of the twinkling effect. So, most of the ornaments made of diamond, we are attracted. Why diamond so costly? What is diamond actually? Diamond is nothing but a carbon. Carbon, tetravalent. Carbon. The carbon become a very costly ornament. Why? What is the reason? Because it's twinkling effect. Why it twinkles? that is a refraction of light. That we are going to see about total internal reflection. In diamond, all the light rays are incident, totally internally reflected out. So that we are having a wonderful effect on diamond, so that we are attracted for diamond ornaments. No one is there. If anybody wearing the diamond ornaments, if you are turned, what happened? Some jolting we are having. So that is the attraction. So that the element is more costlier and also a very rare element to get. So the absolute refractive index, sometimes the question is asked, what is called absolute refractive index? Mu is equal to C by Cm is called absolute refractive index. If the numerator has refractive index to find the absolute value, if velocity of light in air should be taken in the numerator value, if velocity of light through air, then the answer of refractive index is called absolute refractive index. How can you calculate absolute refractive index? Denominator, we least bother about it. Any medium they are given, the numerator should be air. So the refractive index in the numerator divided by velocity of light in the medium will give the value. That value is called absolute refractive index. So I already given mu for vacuum 1, for air 1.003. Therefore, mu 1 is equal to C by C 1, mu 2 is equal to C by C 2. This absolute refractive index, what is called C, velocity of light in air. Therefore, mu 1 C 1 is equal to mu 2 C 2, or mu 2 1 is equal to mu 2 by 1. This is another formula which relates the refractive index. If mu 2 is the refractive index of the second media, mu 1 is the refractive index of the first media, then mu 2 1 is equal to mu 2 by mu 1. Further, since frequency remains constant, don't forget it, as we see in the sound, in light also, when light travels from one medium to another medium, what happens? Its velocity changes, no doubt about it. Its wavelength also changes. The only factor doesn't change is frequency. But the frequency of light remains constant. Therefore, C2 by C1 is equal to lambda 2 by lambda 1. Because we know C is equal to nu lambda. This is a relation between velocity, refractive frequency and wavelength. For first wavelength, C1 lambda 1. For second velocity, C2 is equal to nu lambda 2. We should not put nu 1, nu 2 because frequency remains constant. Therefore, C2 by C1. This nu nu getting cancelled, lambda 2 by lambda 1. That is I have given here. Or mu is equal to lambda 2 by lambda 1. Or mu is equal to lambda by lambda m. This is absolute refractive index. Or mu 2 1 is equal to lambda. Similarly, here C1, C2, here lambda, lambda 2. The same formula we can give. Or mu 1 lambda 1 is equal to mu 2 lambda 2. Because mu into lambda is always constant. That is a thing we have to understand. These are all the some formula related for minor problems. They are asked in the medical entrance examinations. The next one is called for ray from denser medium to rarer medium. Somebody tells, if rarer medium to denser medium, sinalsala. If the light ray travels from denser medium to rarer medium, what happened? So, this is a denser, this is a rarer. If light enters, the refracted ray bend away from the normal. So, it is high, it is R. Now, I increase the value of I, what happen? If I increase the value of I, R value also increases. At a particular value of I, called critical angle, the value of angle of refraction become 90 degree. If I become critical angle, then R become 90. What is the reason? When I increases, R also increases. For a particular value of I, called critical angle, the refraction angle or angle of refraction become 90 degree. That is a case, critical case. Now I increase beyond this value, what happened? If I value increases beyond this, this I, greater than C, what happened? Light rays are not refracted But all the light rays are reflected out. This is the case for total internal reflection. Why the name given for total internal reflection? One thing you have to remember here, even for refraction, the reflection comes. No light on the other media. What happened? Where it comes, it reflected back. So, for refraction, we are getting reflection. So, it is called total internal reflection. Be careful. What are the conditions for total internal reflection? That is a thing you should ask in the examination. What are the conditions? In the blackboard itself, we are having the two conditions. It is visible to our board, our chart, our slide. Kindly note it. So, first condition, light has to travel from denser medium to rarer medium. Second case, angle of incidence must be greater than the critical angle. Light has to travel from denser to rarer, I must be greater than C. Any one of the, any two conditions, these any, not any, these two conditions are satisfied, then only it is called, what is? That is called total internal reflection. The conditions for total internal reflection, number one is, light has to travel from denser medium to rarer medium and I must be greater than C. So, these two conditions must be there. When I greater than C, what happened? So, here reverse is the case. Therefore, Snell's law is also reverse. Snell's law is only for rarer to denser. Here, light travels from denser to rarer. Therefore, we are also interchange sin R by sin I. Am I correct? Sin R by sin I. So, here sin R become 90 degree. When R become 90 degree, what is the value of I? I becomes C. Therefore, sin C. We know sin 90 value become 1. Therefore, 1 divided by sin C. So, this is another formula for refractive index. Mu is equal to mu divided by 1 by sin C. So, 1 we know the critical angle. Once we know the critical angle, the refractive index can also be calculated. 1 by sin C will give the refractive index. So, this is the condition for total internal reflection. This is happening in the diamond. Are you clear? So, these are all the given in the slides, mu1, mu2, for ourselves. There is another thing we have to calculate is mu1, 2 into mu2, 1 is equal to 1. That is a thing. That is a reciprocal. Because 1 by sin c into sin c by 1 cancels out, that value become 1. Or mu1, 2 is equal to sin r by sin I. Or 1 by mu2, 1 is equal to sin I by sin r. So, mu1, 2 into mu2, 1 reciprocal multiply answer become 1. So, this is another concept that is not in our syllabus. What is the concept that we are going to discuss that? That concept is shift of image. When the shift comes, we cannot see the object in the correct place. Why? What is the reason? I already discussed in the thing. One question may be asked. Why sky looks bluish? Usually the question is asked. For that, we can boldly answer it. The amount of scattering inversely proportional to wavelength. Amount of scattering is inversely proportional to wavelength. So, among the seven colors, the shorter wavelength is blue color. You may ask, it starts from violet to red. Violet is the shortest wavelength. So, the violet, indigo, blue. These three colors cannot be distinguished by our human eye. So, the shorter wavelength we can take as blue. The longer wavelength, yellow, orange, red. Maybe we can call it as red. So, you have to keep your mind. Shorter wavelength, blue. Longer wavelength, red. So, why sky looks bluish? Scattering law says, amount of scattering inversely proportional to wavelength. What does it mean? It means wavelength is less, scattering is more. So that shorter wavelength scattered more. Among the seven colors, shorter wavelength is blue color, therefore it is scattered more. So sky and all, even your sea, all are looks bluish. Okay. So consequently, if I ask question, why sun looks reddish during sunset and sunrise? This is immediate next question. If I asked you, if when you see the sun during rise and sun, or anybody had an opportunity to see the sunrise or sunset? That is very difficult to see sunrise, sir, because we are wake up only by 9 o'clock or 10 o'clock. It is not possible. Or at least we are able to see the sunset. When you see the sunset, there is reddish in color. What is the reason? The same argument may be given during sunset and sunrise. This is a sunrise. This is sunset. This is at the noon. If any observer, this is at noon, see the sun. During sunset and sunrise, sun is at a further distance from the observer. It goes very longer distance. Am I correct? If it goes longer distance, what happens? All the shorter wavelength light rays are scattered out. Only longer wavelength come and reach the observer eye. That is a thing we have to understand it. The longer wavelength is called red. So it looks reddish. That is a thing according to light is okay. In subsequently, what is my question? During sunset and the sunrise, sun is further distance from the observer. Okay. All the shorter wavelength light rays are scattered out. Okay. Only longer wavelength alone come and reach the observer eye. My question is, when sun goes further distance or beyond our distance, the size of the sun should be very small, isn't it? If any object going beyond to you, the size of the object going on decreases. Am I correct? If it is very close to you, the pen is very big. If go beyond you, what happen? The size going on decreases. At some other distance, we cannot see the object itself. Whereas, when you see the sun size during set and rise, it is very remarkable. We are wondering, what is the size of the sun? Very, very big. So, when you see the sun, then only you can enjoy. So, when you see the sun, it looks very, very bigger and also reddish. That is a consequence. If the body goes away from the observer, means it has to look very, very small. Instead of very small vicinity, it looks bigger. What is the reason? So, we cannot answer for that. If you understand this answer, that is the shift we can explain. What is the reason for that? I will give another example to you for understanding the subject. Take a 50 paise coin that may be kept inside a beaker containing water. Then observe the size of the coin inside the water. You can observe from air. What happens? It looks bigger. If you take the coin away from the water, again it is the same size. Again dip it into the thing. Even you can enjoy. You can take your finger. So dip your finger inside a water. What is the size of the finger inside the water? What is the size of the finger above the water? You feel. Above the water, same size. Inside the water, we feel bigger size. So what is the reason? Okay. And also you can enjoy when you go to shop, any sweet stall. So when you see anything inside the glass door or inside a jar containing jeera and other thing. So, globe jamun and other thing. When you see from the air, it looks bigger in size. The spherical ball, the size of the globe jamun or anything, rasakulla, when you see in the shop, it looks bigger. So, you want to purchase that, come on, give it one. The shopkeeper took the particular sweet and keep inside a bowl. When you see from the air, it's smaller. When it goes inside, it bigger. You are surprised. What is the reason? For all the thing, you should not confuse. What is the reason for that? Your simple answer is refraction of light. Okay? No, you should not think hardly. So, what is the reason? The object looks bigger when the object may be observed from other media. Your immediate answer may be refraction of light. What is the reason? So that I am given. So, suppose this is a water path. So, this is an object, a coin inside the water. Okay. The light rays coming from the water is a normal drawn. When light travels from denser medium to rarer medium, refracted ray bend away. So, be careful. It not very close. It bend away from the normal. When it away from the normal, anybody watching the object, automatically it looks here only image. That is the thing. So, actually the object at O, therefore actual depth is AO, but our vicinity it is at I. So, it is shift from O to I. So, the image is shifted from actual height to some. So, this is a shift of image. Why? Because when light travels from denser medium to rarer medium, the refracted ray bend. Similarly, the object may be in the rarer medium, observer in the denser medium, reverse is the case. The refracted ray bend towards the normal. There is also shift that we are going to see now. Be careful. That is a thing I have given in the diagram. I draw the diagram for your understanding. So, actual depth is AO. When light rays comes, it bend away. Automatically, what happened? We are seeing the image. Because if it goes like that, so this is a thing. It bends away. So, this is actually a diagram. If light ray goes like that. So, if light ray goes, refracted ray bend away from the normal. Okay. So, when you see the object is not at O, at I. So, there are two depths there. The thickness of the water column T. AO, real depth. AI, this is called image. The AI is called apparent depth. Image appears to be raised. The apparent depth is less than the real depth. Therefore, AI less than AO. Then how can you calculate the refractive index? The formula for refractive index in this case, real depth by apparent depth. So, here real depth AO, apparent depth AI. Therefore, AO by AI will give the refractive index. Apparent depth can be called. This is a formula for finding refractive index. Here apparent depth, how can you calculate it? The apparent depth can be calculated by using the formula T by mu. What is called T? The thickness of the water column divided by refractive index of the water. Therefore, apparent shift can also be calculated by the formula T minus T by mu, or T commonly taken out, T into 1 minus 1 by mu. There are three formulas you have to remember when object is in the denser medium, observer in the rarer medium. Observer means yourself. You are the observer. If you take a coin inside a water, it is called object. Or any globe jamuna or rasakula inside a jeera is called object. So, the apparent depth by or real depth by apparent depth, the distance, simply distance. That means AO by AI will give refractive index. What is the value of apparent depth? Apparent depth T by mu, where mu can be calculated by the above formula, that may be substituted with a thickness, we can able to find out apparent depth, and also shift of image can also be calculated by using the formula T minus T by mu, or T taken out 1 minus 1 by mu. Okay, this is a very important thing. Next is the reverse is the case. Apparent height. If object in the rarer medium, observer in the denser medium. So, this is the distance. When light travels from rarer medium to denser medium, this is a normal. Refracted ray bend towards the normal. Kindly go through it. So, the light travels from rarer medium to denser medium, automatically the refractive ray bend towards the normal. So towards the normal we can extend I. Actually the object must be here. O. That is the object. But it image somewhat height above the thing. Therefore object in rarer medium apparent height by real height. What is apparent height here? Apparent height, this is h dash. How can you find out height h dash? The level of the water into image, new image. So image is not at O, now image is at I. What is the reason? Because when light travels from rarer medium to denser medium, this is the normal. This is the normal. When light travels from rarer to denser, refracted ray bend towards the normal. So it towards the normal means the vicinity is only at a I. In the previous case, the same thing. But AI less than AO. Here AI more than AO. Therefore, apparent AI real AO. Therefore, apparent height by real height. Therefore, apparent height is equal to mu into real height. So how can you calculate apparent height? Apparent height is equal to mu into real height. And mu, refractive index of the medium, into real height how can you calculate it? So we have the h. From the surface of the water, what is the value? That is called h. Apparent shift mu into real height. Mu into real height will give apparent shift. Mu refractive index can be calculated any of the above method into real height. The real height is h dash. Therefore, apparent shift is equal to mu into h dash. Apparent height is equal to mu into again h dash. That is a thing we have to think. This is a thing formula only oriented. So these are the examples I have given in the I already given example to you. One sun looks reddish during sunset and sunrise. This is a wonderful diagram. This is a earth. You are the observer. Apparent position of the sun. This is horizon. This is the actual position of the sun. When light ray coming from one medium to another medium. So since sun is at vacuum, we are at the denser medium when compared to vacuum. Vacuum refractive index is 1 for air, refractive index is 1.003. When you compare this, air has denser medium. Here also when light travel from one medium to another medium, there is a shift of image. So not in the actual position of the sun. If you are seeing observer from the earth, it actually looks at the some other place and the thing. So this is the shift. What is actually happening? Effect of atmospheric refraction on sunrise and sunset. Mu of air greater than free surface. That I already given that 1.003 greater than 1. Due to this, the sun rays are bent on entering the earth atmosphere. Hence, apparent shift in the direction of the sun by half degree. So, actually, actual degree, so it shift will be there half degree from the real position. As a result, sun is visible about 2 minutes before actual sunrise. So, actually, sunrise by 6 o'clock means we can able to see the sun at 5:58 itself, before. And also, if sun set at 6 p.m. means, we are able to see the sunset only at 6 minute and or 6 hours and 2 minutes. So, after sunset and before sunset. So, sun is visible 2 minutes earlier and sun set after 2 minutes. So, the 2 minute gap, what is the reason? Because the angle of the sun from the observer is half degree deviate. Why this half degree deviation? Because of the refraction of light. Why here the refraction taking place? One thing, light has to travel from one medium to another medium. Whether rarer to denser or denser to rarer, definitely the refraction taking place. That refraction effect will, the sun looks bigger and everything. Okay, this is an important thing. Then critical angle, total light reflection, just now I have discussed, I have given by three diagram, 1, 2 and 3. So this all together in one diagram, when light travel from denser medium to rarer medium, denser medium to rarer medium, what happen? Here, light ray traces the separation. Therefore, R become 90. Here also, light rays are reflected in the denser medium itself. That is a thing we have to understand it. So, all the light rays are travels. Because it is incident ray, the incident ray is C. That is, I is equal to C, what happened? 90 degree, if I greater than C, there is a critical angle, all the light rays are totally internally reflected. Therefore, refracted index of the medium mu is equal to 1 by sin C, where IC is called critical angle. If I greater than IC, no refraction, reflected completely into first medium called TIR. What is called TIR? Total internal reflection. Where it happening? Wonderful application has total reflection. I already told you that why diamond, twinkling effect of diamond, and also mirage. Have you heard this word mirage? Mirage. In Tamil you can say it is Kanal Neer. What is a mirage? So during summer season we can able to understand. So on a hot sun, if you are traveling on the road, to your vicinity, some reflection on the road you can enjoy. So if reflection is there, we feel that some water is there. If we go to that place, no water is there. So there is a thing, the mirage, that was happening in most of the place where heat is more. So that is a thing, we have to understand it. So wherever you go, we are having desert area. If you go to desert, we can feel more. Even if you are traveling in desert for a long distance with a loaded with sand and other thing, so hot, we feel so thirsty. So if you are seeing our vicinity, some mirror reflections are there, immediately we think that some water pool is there. So we are rushed to that place. When you reaches that place, again that goes other side. So this is called mirage. Mirage also total internal reflection. Another thing also, by using total internal reflection only, nowadays the transmissions are there. Optical fiber. Have you seen? Optical fiber. So we have to transmit the signal. So we are enjoying the cable connection. In all cable, even in the, so now we are teaching. Everything we are seeing in the net. So the net connection also through that fiber is called optical fiber, the energy, no energy loss is there. What is the reason? Because totally internally reflected, the tube will be there in the tap and the same of fiber. So when light enters, total internal reflected. So everything, even in the binocular or in the scopes are very used where the ship is in the submarine also we can see that periscope also the total internal reflection. Field of view of the fish, this is the usually question asked in the examination. There is a mirage is one example I already given. Another example, field of view of fission of a fish. Have you seen the fish in the tank? We are having an aquarium and other thing. The fish is going, move on here and there. If you give something above the water level, in which way the fish can be seen? The fish can be seen only certain area. What is the reason? So this is the depth. This is a depth. D is called depth. The fish is at the depth. B curve at the end. This is the depth. And this is a radius of cone. What happened? So this angle is called the critical angle. Semi-vertex angle is called critical angle. Here also semi-vertical angle is called critical angle. The radius of the circular path, d depth, mu refractive index of the water, then the radius of the cone always equal to d divided by root of mu square minus 1. R is equal to d divided by root of mu square minus 1. The radius of the cone always equal to d divided by root of mu square minus 1. then substitute it, we can able to find out the value of radius. Cone of half angle is called IC, that is called critical angle, half angle. Cone of half angle will be given the value of IC. A fish inside a pond cannot see outside. What is the reason? So up to this area, fish can be seen. Beyond that, what happened? All the light rays are totally internally reflected. What is the reason? Because here the critical angle is greater than